Two, up, three, four, round, five, six, seven. Okay, you ready? Five, six, seven, clap. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, up. Good. All right. Okay, now this is where you need to make sure that you have a safe place and where your parents have said that you can work on some tumbling. But we're gonna go over some of our tumbling skills and make sure you are acting safely. Don't try anything you aren't sure you can.
So let's go on our knees first. We're gonna stretch our wrists. So pretend you're giving someone a high five, and then we'll take it down. You're gonna rock forwards and backwards. Good, and then go ahead and give that high five again. Turn it to the left and right, and then take it down, side to side. Good, and then continue to turn those fingertips facing your knees. Again, get some good rocks.
And like we talked about, how important it is for cheerleaders to have ankle strength, wrist is as important. So please, always be doing your wrist stretches, your wrist exercises.
Now let's clasp those fingers together. We're gonna roll them around. Very nice. Okay, now we're ready for our tumbling.
Okay, so for back bends, you're gonna start laid back. Most of you know this, make sure hands are back behind, feet are apart and flat as you push up. You wanna pull that belly button up as you push up into that back bend. You wanna make sure your feet stay flat. Some of you are ready to do your lift legs as you're in your back bend. And then some of you are actually ready to start like this, put one foot up and do your back bend, okay?
Now again, it's always nice to be able to lift those legs, but if they're not straight with that pointed toe, with a good form, it's kind of pointless, okay? So really watch that, especially if you're gonna start like this and push up. Watch where you start and think, lead that toe towards the ceiling when you push through, okay? So once you do your back bend drills, if you are ready to, we can have you start up in a nice stretch and lead it back into your back bend, all the way down to your hands.
Right, and if you're a parent and they're almost ready and you want to do some spotting, don't just spot their back. Make sure you've also got them on their shoulders as they're going back. Very good.
Okay, and we've also started standing nice and tall, jumping out with your feet apart into a nice clasp, and then taking it down with your hands apart into that back bend. Okay, so let's practice that. We're squeezing nice and tall. So five, six, seven, clap up. One, two, take it back. All the way down to your hands. Okay, nice and strong motions. Good. Okay, next.
All right, next is our rolls. So as we do our rolls, it's very important everyone tucks their head as we tell our younger ones to look at your belly button. And then make sure the goal is to stand up without any hands. So if you're still needing help standing up without your hands, a parent, anyone else can help. I'm gonna help Cheyenne stand up right now.
So feet together, reaching up nice and tall, taking it down with bent knees, looking at your belly button, tuck that head so the back side of your head should be touching the mat. Taking it down,
and look
reach.
Where her feet do not go out.
They're from the side, they're not here.
They're right by your booty. And then you can help pull them up.
Good. Let's try it again. Feet together, reach up tall, taking it down and tuck. No hands.
Don't use those hands to stand up.
Very nice. Now that might take some time, but if you keep practicing even a couple a day, you will see a huge improvement in these.
All right, our cartwheels. We are so thrilled with the progress of our cartwheels in our younger cubs and our older ones. A lot of them came with cartwheels. But make sure you know which foot you're doing. If you're having some trouble, try the other foot, but most of you already know which foot you do. So put one foot out, stretch super tall, and remember, whichever foot's out, that's the side you're gonna go to.
Mm-hmm. So right is this way. If you're switching it, same drill, other way. Now with that foot coming out, you wanna make sure you have that good lunge position, but it's not this type of lunge, okay? So lock out that back knee, foot should be flat, both feet should be flat, pushing out, okay? So we're reaching up tall, squeezing those ears, locked out, reach out, and up.
And you want to end facing the wall that was behind you as much as you can.
Okay, so let's try it again. In that good lunge, reaching up nice and tall, walk those arms, reach out, push through those toes, lunge, hold it, and then turn. If you have the space, you can keep going multiple. Okay?
Also, a lot of you were working on one-handed, whichever foot you put out, right or left, that's the hand that goes up here. And they can do the y'all
hand
can
is going down. One-handed. You'll be kicking into that ending lunge again.
And several of you were also working on round offs where you snap. I'm gonna have Cheyenne just demonstrate a standing round off.
Let me go from this side.
From this side. There you go.
Okay, so good lunge. Mm-hmm.
Snap at the top, turn down. Good. And our older classes were working on our two steps. If you do a right cartwheel, make sure you step right, right, left. Cartwheel. If you're a lefty, left, right, and you can add this little hop before it. I'm going to let Cheyenne just do her two-step wrap-up.
Step, hop.
Good.
Very nice.
All right.
Now, if you have a lot of power from those round-offs, there is no rule that tells you you cannot add that rebound. Okay? It's actually better to get that habit. So from this lunge, you'll be snapping, jumping up. Into our huge hop, good position, chest is up.
Squeezed. All right, our last thing is our handstands. You do whatever foot you do a cartwheel on. So if you're a right cartwheel, you put your right foot out. If you've got these pretty good, a lot of you are really getting good at these, and parents, you wanna help, you can grab their legs. If there's a wall you don't mind them putting their feet on, that's another good way to practice. But you start in your lunge like your cartwheel right away. Younger ones, you might want to get push to make sure those elbows are strong. Okay.
Once I take it down, I see where my hands go, and then I look behind me at the back wall. Okay, so I'm reaching up, nice and strong, and look back. Good.
And one foot down.
One foot down.
And when you're up there, toes pointed, squeeze, tight bodies, tight bodies, tight bodies.
I'll show you one more, and then we'll talk about that.
Okay. If you're balancing super good, a way a parent or somebody can do is to make sure those legs are tight and they're so squeezed that we can't pull them apart. Good job.
Very nice.
A reminder again, please find a safe place to do these. Okay.
Okay, so that was our tumbling. There's no limit to whatever else y'all want to practice, but go through those steps, try a couple a day so you can improve. Okay, so go ahead and get that object that we talked about grabbing for our drills. But before we start these, just to clarify, we do have the first part of this video on YouTube, and then we also were living it on our Facebook page, but for some reason it ended on us, but both will be on this YouTube channel. Okay, so go ahead and get your object. We're gonna put it in front of you in that straddle. Okay, now your straddle doesn't want to be the biggest you can get. Okay, bring in a little bit. Go ahead and split your leg with both of your hands. And you're going to lift your toe straight up and down. Good, the goal is not to touch that heel. Okay, probably get like 10 on this side. Bring it in if you start to cramp. Relax those muscles. Bring it back up, split the other leg. Go ahead and get your 10. Good, bring it in. Very nice. Now get your objects. Put it at the same level and distance as your ankle. Okay, you're gonna split that foot again. You're gonna take it over, half circles. So don't just swipe it over. You wanna think, take it down, up and over, down, up and over. Good, get 10, so you'll do 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way to 10, and then switch it to the other side. 10 over, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Now for our pikes, we're gonna take our toes a little bit to the corner. So this wants to be in line with your hips and your belly button. Fingers are facing your heels. You're gonna bend those elbows a tad. You're gonna take it over. Same thing we just did in that straddle. But now our feet are together, all the way. Good, again, 10 is the number. Once you're done, then you're gonna bring it in and out, in and out. 10 is the goal. You can always bump up that number when you're ready. Good. And we're done with our workout. But again, if you have any other recommendations for workouts that you do at home, there is no rule that you can't do those as well.
Now, make sure if you are a green cub, pink and black cub, whatever color cub you are, on our YouTube channel is your actual dance. Cheyenne has also done all of the cheers. When we are ready to have our recital, which I know we will, each class will only do one cheer and their dance, but we're not sure which class will do each cheer, so make sure you're practicing all of them too, and your dance. So when we come back, we only need a few practices.